It needs me.
I'm needed.
The yearbook needs me.
Yearbook needs me.
Yearbook was not that easy. We had to take the picture as well as edit them and put them on.
There is a lot of work and pages that has to be finished in a certain amount of time.
Didn't realize there was going to be this much work. At first, I thought it would be putting pictures in templates only, but it's not that simple. There are many more things to do, such as photo taking and page layouts.
People might think it's like a chill class, but we take things seriously in yearbook and try to do our best to make the yearbook look good as possible. We work hard.
When I first entered yearbook, I thought we were going to use a program like Photoshop, which I already know how to use, but instead, we used Justin's. Since then, I had a hard time working with the program, but I managed to learn how to use it. I also wasn't expecting this much work.
Top tips for a tip-top yearbook. Number one, be prepared. The first top tip of Yearbook Club is be prepared. This is to do with organization. You don't just want nasty shocks, like no battery or internet failure from stopping you. You have to bring all the gear that will make your time in the yearbook easier. Such as bring your laptop, your charger, your phone, your camera, all the connection cables. Sit down, open your laptop, and begin.
Tip number two, finish the yearbook work first. It takes up way more time than other classes' work. Well, aside from chemistry, the yearbook group goes to interview people around the school as well as sitting in front of the laptop working. The clock is ticking really fast, so you need to stay focused and avoid all distraction around you. Things might be distracting during class, don't mind them and stay focused. Tip number three, the yearbook is printed in 5 sections throughout the year, not at the end. You will be given regular deadlines for the pages in the book. If you miss a deadline, you slow down the process of the book. The deadlines are real and you are working as a professional. In real life, if you miss a deadline, you get fired. In your book, if you miss a deadline, your grade will go down. Just stay on top of things and you'll be fine.
Tip number four, follow the theme. This will allow the reader to relate continuous altogether to a certain topic. Here's an example of a theme in the title page. The theme of this page are triangles and diamond shapes. The page that have to do with department therefore now have triangles and diamond shaped photos. They have a connection to previous pages.
Tip number 5. Try to keep the fonts consistent on every page so that it does not look too busy. Choose for fonts that look fancy and captivating for the readers, yet simple at the same time. In addition, by using a combination of font type and styles that are opposite from one another, like bold with skinny or cursive with regular, it lures the readers into what you are trying to write.
Tip number 6, always save your work.
Okay, so in Justin, it's really important that you save every now and then. So here's a save button, and please use it like every 5 minutes so that you don't lose all your work.
Tip number 7, make appointments with teachers and students you want to interview and keep track of them. Always make sure to plan your appointments in advance and arrive early to the designated time and place, so teachers will be more willing to come the next time you interview them. Don't forget to show appreciation for the teachers who took their time to come and meet you, so say thank you. A little appreciation wouldn't hurt anyone.
Tips number 8. Don't scare to go ask people for the interview. If there are students or teacher who doesn't reply your emails, don't just sit and wait because you never know when they're going to reply or even if they have checked their emails. Just figure out what room they're in, knock on their doors, and interview them. If they're not in their rooms, just chase them and get whatever information you need.
Tip number 9. Simplicity is beautiful. Try to keep pages as simple as much as you can. When pages have too many things on them, such as pictures, it can give the reader a hard time trying to focus. So, align the text and photos, try leaving some space, and focus on quality over quantity. It looks neater that way. Play with text by using typography, and not every color in the rainbow, but a restricted color palette.
Tips number 10. Yearbook can sometimes be stressed because all the deadlines are real. When it's due, then it's due. The pages would be sent off to print in sections, which sometimes could create a stress due to overload of homework from other classes, as well as some information might gone missing for finishing the page. Also, there are some effort that needed to be put in. But remember, don't be stressed. Just relax, enjoy working, and be creative.
I think the main reason for making a yearbook is that we want to capture memories into like picture frames. So like we can actually tell other people about what has happened during that year. That's why we call it a yearbook.
To capture your moments with your friends, and throughout the year you have made memories, and you want to keep those memories.
Everyone has their own picture in it, and it shows everything that happened throughout the year in the school. And shows which person it is in which homeroom, and in case you want to know someone's name, there's also their name in the yearbook.
I actually enjoy the whole yearbook, but like my favorite one would be the sports section.
The sports section?
On the sports section.
Sports section. This, having to take pictures of them, actually see them in action.
Because it involves more camera, like taking pictures skill, and I think I'm okay. That's one of the categories that I did well.
Pictures that we wanted, and like all like interactions with like the people in the teams, and take all the motion, so I think it's like the most enjoyable thing.
I like making the baby pictures pages, yeah. Because you get to see, as a yearbook staff, you get to see the baby photos of the teachers before anyone else, and it's pretty fun.
I think Justin is good at like taking care of like our deadlines, because also when it writes on our page like when's the deadline due, and it also like alerts ourselves that like when, every time we open Justin's and we look at the page ladder, it tells us when the due date is and who's our partner.
You know, there's also a lot of layouts that they already give you, which is
easy to use, and then you can just like put the template in, and then you just like drag the pictures in, and like it's easy to like put in the fonts.
You know, like it's easy to manage because like you know your place, you know where you are, you have like your name right next to the page you should be doing, and also like many people can access it at once, so
compared to like if you're using Photoshop, you cannot having more than one person.
I learned to Photoshop.
In Photoshop?
Photoshop.
Photoshopping.
And that's the reason why I actually joined Yearbook.
That's one thing I've always been wanting to learn how to do.
It's pretty useful in my everyday life too.
And also about fonts and how different fonts are used to incorporate even another to keep the eye focused.
For like putting in like the cutouts and like how to make like the edge like smoother, and also like how to use the variety in fonts and how to make like the header like more interesting.
If you do all your work, it can be really fun. If you can manage all your time, you can survive like so easy in this class.
Take care of your problems and about something you're good at, you should try to like do that more. Like,
to stick on task.
To always stay on task.
Know what your deadlines are and then stick to that deadlines and be prepared every time.
They should start their work early and use time in class as effectively as possible, so that when you go back home you don't have to like have that much work, and if you have problems you can ask like Ms. K. So like try to use the time in class like as efficiently as possible.
Classmates, they're like really nice and fun to work with.
It like kind of fun, the teamwork, which like we get closer and we can like share some ideas, and then which idea is good, which idea is bad, we can like discuss together. So I think that the atmosphere of the class is quite like enjoyable.
Close environment, because you get to interact with all your
In my class it was really like peaceful because there's only like, 3 people. So it was like kind of peaceful and like calm, so not noisy, not distracting.
Probably the thing I enjoy most is like when I know the page is submitted and there's like I'm done with the work, and like, and also like when I'm making this video right now, it's actually quite fun.
Putting that, I'm part of this yearbook, and like when the yearbook like prints out and I'm like, oh, I did that page.
When I open Justin and it says the yearbook is completed and then shoots out all the fireworks.
I think it's my Photoshop skills. It's gotten a lot better.
I enjoy like editing the page and like kind of move things around to see like what looks good and what doesn't.
Going out and learning about the photo taking techniques, mm-hmm. because we get to do a lot of like action activities, like going outside, going to see like the elementary kids like play their sports, and we can learn about new techniques to make the yearbook more interesting to the reader.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world.
You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile.